Well, here comes my main man.
Simon Dean.
Hey, baby.
Simon
give me one. I think you did. The Simon System Bar. You know, I eat these every day. That's why the coach looks the way that he does. And you, well, you're pretty self-explanatory. I just forgot mine today. A little unorthodox, but now, I mean, these two could be more suited for each other.
Why? Because they're both clowns?
Maven and Simon Dean may have, well, been bitten off more than they chew, but against these two guys are taking on right here, Chad Collier and Russell Simpson.
This tag team they call CM Dawn, wasn't that a rap group from like 10 years ago?
That was PM Dawn.
Oh, I was close.
And coach, this tag team is actually called CM Punk.
I don't care what they're called. The coach is only concerned with how his guys, Maven and Simon Dean, look to the entire world. Physically, they look great. Now they have to look great in the ring. Do you understand that?
Let me ask you this. Is Hulk Hogan one of your guys, so to speak?
He hasn't been in years past. He's not right now.
Why?
I mean, did you see that ridiculous ovation he got at the Hall of Fame induction ceremony? One more match. One more match. And now, see, Maven's looking fantastic right here. And now Shawn Michaels is saying, hey, come back for one more match. Team up with me, the Heartbreak Joke, to take on Daivari and Hassan.
Well, hey, Shawn Michaels was totally confident and secure facing both Muhammad and Daivari all by his lonesome in a handicap match. But it was Eric Bischoff that told the Heartbreak Kid, as we see a cover there, that he needed a tag team partner.
You always have to blame it on somebody else. The bottom line is, Shawn Michaels really didn't want to face Daivari and Hassan by himself. He wanted to have a tag team partner deep down.
Well, he went straight to the top, didn't he? Asking Hulk Hogan, who Heartbreak Kid said was sitting at home watching Raw, said Hulk Hogan, one more match. And you heard the fans chant with
him. You can hear the fans right now chanting a not so flattering chant. And that's the answer that Maven has for the fans.
What a drop kick by Maven. The real result in a win, no, a two count.
And now Maven and Simon Dean in the square, as I like to call them. They're just toying with CM Punk. They're just toying with these guys, showing the crowd how great they can be. And maybe showing the new tag team of the Heartbreak Kid and Hulk Hogan, maybe Daivari and Hassan aren't the only tag team they need to worry about.
Whoa! Well, one man that no one will need to worry about in the WWE, at least for a few more months, is Randy Orton, who just underwent shoulder surgery. We'll show you that surgery, portions of it, following this match, and trust me, it is very graphic.
Yeah, very, very graphic. If you have a queasy stomach, you may want to turn away.
I will.
We don't care if you turn away. We just want you to go away.
Well, Simon Dean went straight down to the mat, and all of a sudden, CM Punk is having a pretty good night, and Maven and Simon Dean are on the ropes.
That was a horrible analogy, and it's not going to even matter.
Look at this, teaming up and down.
Somebody cover these guys.
Hook in the leg from
Maven. Forget about it.
And it is over.
Man, he looks great. He wrestles great. He smiles great. He growls great. Simon Dean just makes everybody else great. It's all about making everybody else's life better. And that's what Simon Dean does.
They said this would be a very impressive, emphatic victory, and that it was not, coach.
No,
these two struggled. They struggled.
That it was, and I'm begging this kid from CM Punk to get down, because it's time for somebody to eat a little something.
Oh, this is, come on. This is ridiculous.
Hey.
Oh, God.